What's going on, guys? My name is Nick Foy, the founder of Nick Foy TV, where we teach you tutorials on how to make websites, as well as real estate investing and finance tips. Today, we are talking about Elementor. Elementor is a free plugin you can install on a WordPress website to build pages. We're building a custom page. Now, in today's video, we're strictly going over the button widget that comes with Elementor to show you all the different settings and how to use the button widget. So what I want to do first is add a new section. So I might add a single full width page section here. Now, if I'm building out a page and I want to use a button, typically my page might start off with like a heading widget, and then I might drag and drop in the video widget next. So I could start off by saying, you know, hey, here's 21 tips on how to build a website. Then I could show them a video on how to build their website in 21 steps or 21 tips. And then if I had a call to action in my video, that might say, you know, join my free 7-day how to start a blog course below. Then they could have the button down below the video that they could click on to get access to that free course. So once you've added a button widget out here on the page, we would want to click on this little pencil icon. And what that's gonna do is open up the editing settings for that button. So here we are, we can see it says edit button up here at the top of the Elementor dashboard. So we know these are the settings for the button. We've got the content tab, the style tab, and the advanced tab. So for the content tab, we can see the different default settings that are already here for the button. So button type is set to default. Now we can change it to info success, warning, or danger. This just changes the color of the button to some default settings. So if we did info, it would change it to blue. If we did success, it would change it back to green. Warning is gonna be this yellowish color. And then danger is gonna be more of a red. So we're gonna go ahead and just click back to the default to make it green. Now text, we can put our text here. So I could say, you know, sign up for the free blogging course. So this could be my button text. Then I would link out to that page where they're gonna be signing up. So it'd be like an email opt-in page where it would have an email form to collect their name and their email address so they could get all subscribed to my email newsletter and start getting that free blogging course emailed to them. So that's the link. We could create different link options here if we want to open in a new tab. You can also paste in PDF links here if you wanted to just give away like a download. You know, we could have made this a download button as well. It would just say something like that. And then we'd link out to the PDF so when they click that, it would open up the PDF page for them to download. Now alignment, we could do left, center, or right alignment. If I was putting it under the video, I might center align it. There's also this setting called justified. And that spreads it out the entire width of whatever section or column the button is in. So since this is a full width section, the button becomes full width of that page. So that's another option as well. Now if I wanted to clean this up and make it look a little bit better, what I could do here is just add a new column, and I'll add another new column, and we're gonna drag this first column on the left hand side so that our video section is now in the middle. And we're just gonna adjust the column width settings here, width percent. So I'm gonna make this 15, and then on the other side, we're gonna change this to 15 as well. So this could theoretically be, you know, my little landing page where I'm trying to drive email subscribers to my email list or sign people up to a free course of mine. All right, so we've got our heading, we've got our video, we've got our button. Now this button spans the width of this column. So it looks a lot better than a minute ago when we had it full width and it was stretched all the way across the screen. So now the spacing of it looks a little bit better. So we'll go back here into the edit icon to continue editing it. We can set the size here if we were using just the regular button. So as you change the size though, from small to medium to large, the height of the button gets bigger and bigger. So if we go to large, it gets even bigger. If we go to extra large, now it's really big. So we'll go back down to more of like a medium sized button there. Now icons we can add to our button. So if we want to open up the icon library, it might look for like a down signal arrow that would, you know, go with the download text on my button here. And then we can adjust the icon position. So we could put it before, we could put it after, we could put some spacing with the button here. So there's different settings you can play around with here, but those are the general settings that come on this first content tab. There's only one tab here that drops down called button. And those are the different settings you can change. Next, we want to go into the style tab. Here's where we can get more particular about the font. So we can go into typography here and we can update the family for the font. So right now it's set to Roboto. We can update the size so I can make the size of my text bigger. And as you see there, it'll also change the size of the button. We can also change the font weight, which is how bold the text is, so I can move it up to 700. We can transform the text, change the style or the decoration, line height, and letter spacing. So after playing around with our font, we can next go to the different effects when somebody hovers over the button. So first we're gonna click on the hover section, and I'm gonna actually change the background color to a different color just so you can see the difference. So I'm gonna set the background color to black. We'll leave the text color as is. So now when somebody hovers over that button, it changes from green to black. So that's a little animated motion effect that can happen on the screen by just changing the settings under hover. So you can compare the two by going back and forth between normal and hover to make changes so that as they hover over the button, some kind of action happens that stands out to catch their attention or catch their eye, make your web page a little more interesting. Next, we've got padding and border radius. So these are going to be spacing options if we want to try to adjust the space of our button. So you can add some padding here and it'll make your button more curvy. Right now, my button is more of a rectangle. So as we would add a bunch of, you know, space here, it's just going to make our button change sizes. So overall, content style, pretty straightforward. Let's go into our final tab here called advanced. Now this is gonna be where we're adjusting size and spacing above the actual column element for the button. So if we wanted to give some space between our video and our button here, we could just add some top margin here by adding some space. So as you can see, we're going down the page further and further as we increase the margin there. Same with if we needed to increase space below the button. If there was something else underneath, we could do so by adjusting the bottom margin. If you decide to make your button a pop-up form for email capture, you can add some CSS classes and IDs here. So there are some pop-up plugins you could download in your WordPress library. And once you create your pop-up form, there's usually going to be some sort of like little code that you would then come paste in here. And that could create this button to be a pop-up, so when somebody clicks on it, it just pops the form up rather than reload them to a new page. In addition to this advanced tab, we can work our way down here to motion effects. So we can go into default and we can choose one of these motion settings. So I'm gonna go ahead and just do slide in from the left. So here's where the button would slide in from the left. If we wanted to change it, we could just go back here and we could do roll in. And you can see how the button kind of came rolling in on the screen there. We also have background, which would be the settings behind the button if we wanted to change the color or any type of thing behind the background. Border, positioning, responsiveness. Responsiveness might be handy if you decide that you don't want this button to display on a certain type of website. So if you're on desktop, tablet, or mobile devices, you could choose to hide the button if you wanted to. Maybe you have an optimized button that's only for mobile and you have an optimized button only for desktop. You could create two different buttons here and you could just hide the ones on their respective platforms that you don't want them to show up for. Any additional custom CSS you can actually code in here under the custom CSS widget down below. So overall, those are the three different tabs where you can edit different settings for your button. The basics are just adding in your different content. So the text, if you want an icon, what you want the button to do, do you want it to link out somewhere? How do you want to align your button? And then you can go into style and get more particular with your color of your button as well as the font settings, and then you can add a hover effect to your button as well. So thanks for checking into this quick tutorial on how to use the Elementor button widget. It is one of the main widgets you get with the Elementor plugin. My name is Nick Foy, the founder of Nick Foy TV. I appreciate you checking into this tutorial today. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel if you like this style of content and you want more website tutorials. We also cover real estate investing, stock market investing, and other finance topics in addition to learning how to market and grow a self-made business.